What happened?
Daddy back.
Daddy did what?
Daddy back.
Oh, okay. You gonna get Daddy's bag?
It's his way.
Okay, you can get it and help him.
It's heavy.
Oh, can you get it?
I can't.
Oh, well, just wait for Daddy, okay?
Daddy
come? Yeah, wait for Daddy to come. Alrighty, so we're on our way to Dallas. We're going to the state fair. It's actually the last weekend of the state fair. Every year I say I'm gonna go, and I never get around to going. So for Dallas's birthday, we said that we were gonna take him. This year he actually was excited about going. Previous years he said that it was too far of a drive, but now he's like, you know, kind of like into those kind of things, so. He's pretty excited, so we're packing up. Somebody's excited. Are you excited, Mama? Are you excited?
Yeah.
Yes! Where are we going?
We're going to Uncle Chris' house. Halloween.
Yes! Little translation, we're going to Uncle Chris's house and we're going to have Halloween. Basically, to sum that up, we're going to go see Uncle Chris, which is my brother-in-law, and we're going to have a little Halloween party kind of get-together thing. I got a whole bunch of stuff to like make like a charcuterie board and then like drinks and stuff or whatever. So Berkeley has been seeing me prep for that, so she's pretty hyped about that. So we're going to be having Halloween. So. Good morning, y'all. We finally made it to Dallas, obviously, yesterday. Currently getting ready to head out to go to the fair. Y'all, it has been so crazy. Well, we picked up Dallas from school yesterday. I don't know what it is. He kinda, he had a cough, like this dry cough or whatever. And we were just like, okay, that's kind of like weird. Are you okay? And he was like, yeah, I'm fine, whatever. And so, like, as we, like, made our first stop on our way to Dallas, because, like, from Houston to Dallas, it's about 4 hours to get here. We stopped to eat. Dallas did not want to eat. He looked like he just was not feeling very well. So, I was like, okay, we need to go get him some medicine for his cough at least. And then I kind of felt him and he felt warm. So I was like, while I'm in here buying him medicine, I'm going to go ahead and buy a thermometer just to take his temperature because we're going to be traveling, you know, coming here, exposing ourselves around other people. I want to make sure, you know, he doesn't have a fever or anything like that. And it's like more than just a cough. Why did this boy have 101 temperature? So then I was like, oh my gosh, we were like 2 hours into our drive. We called and we were like, we're not coming, blah, 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 blah. You know, everyone was bummed or whatever. We were not even near anywhere where I could get like a Rona test or whatever. So anywho, long story short, we ended up driving, trying to find somewhere to get a test. Found a test, y'all. It was negative. we called in, you know, my mother-in-law and everything. My mother-in-law is a nurse, by the way. We called in, checked with everybody. It was like, okay, he's testing negative, but he still has this fever and this cough. How do you guys feel with us still coming, you know? Everyone was fine. It was like, come, you know, blah, blah, blah. Again, my mother-in-law is a nurse, so she was just like, you know, she's seen an increase in other things, you know, right now going on. But the main concern is, you know, Rona, because that will put people out of work and just all kinds of stuff or whatever. We came, and in the middle of the night last night, Dallas, he came and he woke me up and he was just like crying. He was like, I don't feel good. I don't feel good. Y'all, I took his temperature. He had 104 temperature. 104 temperature. So I'm up by myself at like 4 o'clock in the morning with Dallas, and I'm just like, and then I wake Charles up and I'm like, babe, Dallas has 101 temperature. And he jump up, he was like, go tell my mama. And so he was like, I was in here trying to put my clothes on because Dallas was in one of the guest rooms on the other side of the house. And so I could hear her. She yelled when Charles saw her, and she was like, y'all need to take him to the ER. Took him to the ER. They tested him for strep, Rona, flu. He has the flu, y'all. So unfortunately, Dallas will not be going to the state fair. We really came here to celebrate his birthday because this was like one last thing for his birthday. We were celebrating because we were going to come the first weekend that it opened, but I had to get my hair braided for our cruise. So he's not going to be able to go. I really hate that. So sad. And the doctor even told him, he was like, dude, even if you go to the fair, within 30 minutes, you're going to be feeling like crap. So just stay home. Let your grandma take care of you. You know, stay hydrated. All that good stuff. So it's just been it's been a struggle. And I did prepay for tickets before we got here. So I kind of feel like, I don't know, we probably still would have went. Well, maybe not. If I hadn't already bought the tickets, we probably wouldn't even go because we're gonna just do like a Halloween party tonight. We were gonna do it last night, but we were tired. We just stayed up and we watched like the cruise vlog and we talked about cruises and all that kind of stuff. So tonight we're gonna have to make up for Dallas not being able to go to the fair with us. So we're definitely gonna be doing our little Halloween, I call it a Halloween party, but it's basically just like food and, you know, Halloween treats and stuff. So I gotta make it special for my baby. Boy, I've been watching you. Are you ready? What are we about to do? We're gonna see the animals. Oh my gosh, are you so excited? Yes! It's so roomy and sporty. I like it.
This is an electric Nissan. It's called the... This is the interior of it. It's pretty interesting. This is kind of cute. This is an electric car, Kia. Someone in our neighborhood has this car. I don't even know what it's called. Let me see if I can find the thing. But it's really like sleek looking. I like it. It's called the EV6 GT. It's about $54,000.
Okay, so we're actually about to get a margarita. I gotta put this hat back on because I don't have any sunglasses. We're about to get a margarita and some fried Oreos. Just until we make it to the side that has the good stuff. Fried Oreos. We got a margarita and Kim got...
Tickets is $10.
14 tickets and 6 tickets. How much was your shot?
8 tickets.
8 tickets.
Alrighty, so now we're in here looking at the truck. We're basically cutting through here to set eyes on the trucks to go find the fried charcuterie board.
Propulsion system gives it that 400 miles of range on a full charge, and GM estimates that you can get 100 miles back in approximately 10 minutes using that DC fast charge system. You can even charge another EV with this truck, EV being electric vehicle.
There he is. So we're actually going to do the fried pickles instead of the avocado fries. We'll take some fried pickles. Here's the pickles. It tastes like regular fried pickles.
Nothing special.
You need that sauce.
What kind of sauce?
At least I'm fried hard.
Not salty. Put some jalapeno ranch over here. Y'all need to get some jalapeno ranch.
They got ranch or something?
Jalapeno ranch. Ooh, it's bees over here. Ooh. And so he's trying it with the ranch now.
Y'all get jalapeno?
Tastes good. Mm.
Kim, did you try?
Try with the ranch.
Is that the same ranch?
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes a difference.
Yeah.
That's a difference. Yep.
That's it right there.
Here, Mama.
This is fried charcuterie board. It's good.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah, would you try the Bellini?
What's all in this fried charcuterie board?
Salami, apples, goat cheese. Is it caramel drizzle?
And some apples.
Honey or something.
Oh, honey.
It was worth 16 tickets?
No.
Oh, all right, so we ended up getting fried banana pudding, lettuce, and French fries.
Bush.
It was so much food in there. Yeah, it was like so overwhelming. I had to put my hair up. Partially. This is the fried banana pudding.
The sauce good? My grandma made it. They fried the mess out of it.
They have fried everything.
Just fried banana pudding now.
What you think? It's good.
It's like beef. It tastes like shrimp.
I think it's weird.
Kim, you would like this rib, girl. It's seasoned good.
we got the spicy ribs. So you could get like original or spicy. Nachos, I'm going to be making some punch, and we're going to be doing like a charcuterie board.
I got this, I showed you guys in a vlog months ago that I got from Home Goods. I'm going to put you in the punch in here. I got these cute little cups for Dallas and Berkeley from one of the dollar stores. I've had this for years for Berkeley's gender reveal. We did a Halloween themed gender reveal. So yeah, this is like all of the stuff that we have. Dallas is tearing his Kool-Aid pickle up and his turkey leg that we brought him back from the fair. How's that pickle?
Bussing.
What do you have? Oh, she has stickers. Girl, look what she doing with stickers. Show TT. Hey, hey. So Kim brought Berkeley a present, and she has stickers.
I don't understand why you're thinking of me. You had me at a low.
So cute. And then turn this on.
Like 6 months, y'all, we're picking up our chairs. Do y'all remember the chairs? Do y'all remember the chairs?
I don't even know what they look like.
We're finally about to pick
are
up the chairs.
Black?
No.
But where are we supposed to go? Or do what? I don't even know.
Yeah, I'm like, you don't have no directions or nothing?
I just got my order number.
Maybe go talk to the...
Where do we go? We go in here. You gonna take this? Alright, so we're about to get the chairs finally out. Finally. Oh, crap.
Crate and Barrel, CB2. So this is basically the warehouse for Crate and Barrel and CB2. So it's been since May that I ordered these. This is October. So yeah, hopefully they fit. That's basically. What if they don't fit, y'all?
I got a notification that my credit card was charged the other half of the money. Because what happened is back in May, they charged half of the amount of the order, and they were going to charge the other half of the amount once the order was processed, basically once it was in stock. So I never got any type of confirmation saying, hey, your order is finally in stock. I just got a notification that my credit card was charged the other half. So once that happened, I logged into my CB2 account and I saw that I can go ahead and select a date. So I didn't get any type of notification or anything from CB2 saying that I could go ahead and select a date. The only type of notification that alerted me to go ahead and log into my account was just the fact that my card was charged.
So these are the chairs that took 6 months, or how long? 4 months, 5 months. Oh, they're gonna fit. Perfect.
Hope these are everything that we've been waiting a whole year for.
You don't wait till I come in and help you, or you already know?
I don't think I need you. You already did the hard part.
Yeah. Get your food. Got something, Mama?
Guess what? Come on the box. Close your eyes, babe. Surprise.
Someone's at the door.
Here they are. What do you think, Dallas?
Perfect for me. Yeah. Very nice.
Very nice. We don't know how we feel about the chairs. All of that waiting, and we just don't know. I love the way that they look from this viewpoint from here. Like, it looks so good. But I just think they're too small. I don't know. Dallas, what do you think about the chairs? They look so good from like right here.
That's the only angle they look good.
What do you think? You don't think they look good in here?
Never mind. Y'all?
Is that your toe?
Oh yeah, this looks cool.
What looks cool?
All these different chairs and stuff.
Trying to see which one looks good.
Oh. Keep different ones. Yeah, it's like modern.
I think that I might can get with the new ones over on that side. With the couch, the little sectional, or the little piece of the couch over here, and then these right here.
Okay, y'all, so before I just really dedicate and commit to these chairs that I order, I'm gonna try them out at my dining room table, and I'm gonna put the dining room chairs in my bedroom to see exactly how they look. As of right now, I have the new chairs that I bought in my bedroom, but I just feel like they're such like a statement piece that I want them to be seen in a more common area. Like, our bedroom is not high traffic. We're the only ones that's really going to be seeing them. And as long as I waited for these chairs, I really want them to be in a common area as a statement piece. They were originally meant to be for the living room, but as I told you guys, anything as far as these chairs that I order, they're meant to be able to be used in my dining room, my living room, or in our bedroom. So they're in our bedroom. They look great, but once again, they just have such a wow factor. I kind of want them to be like in this area because this is what I'm trying to finish up. Like, I'm really not even concerned about our bedroom right now. So I'm just like, I waited all of that time. I could have went ahead and finished my living room already. I was waiting for those chairs though. Anywho,
these are the chairs that I have in my dining room right now. I'm talking about these two end chairs. I haven't had them that long. I ordered these from Target. I'll link the video here somewhere, the description box, the end card at the end of this video or whatever. But these are the chairs. So now, what I'm trying to finish tying up is I'm trying to decide which chairs I'm going to have in my dining room, because next on the list is ordering a rug for the dining room.
Now, this may be a total surprise to you guys, but I'm actually thinking about a rug with some color. In particular, I want like a green, like a sage green. I think that'll look so pretty. It's still kind of like an earth tony color or whatever, but I just want something to like tie in some color. I see. I think it'll also top the greenery. I do want to put some more greenery maybe in our living room. Yeah, so rug, let's figure out these chairs, then I can hang up my pictures and we'll be able to go from there. Okay, I really love these chairs here, but we'll see. I don't even think I tested the new chairs there yet, but I'm like, okay, you know, it can have some dimension because all eight of those chairs are basically the same height or whatever. So we'll see. As of right now, I kind of feel like the chairs definitely will not be going in the living room though, because I don't know. I don't know. We'll just see. Let's see how the new chairs look over here first and see how these look in my bedroom.
Satisfied with them for now anyway.
They look good.
So yeah, I definitely like the fact that there's some different dimension here. I'm gonna get my pictures hung up, and then we're gonna get a rug. Probably gonna get some curtain, tie back hook things. And I may, yeah, we'll be done in here. That'll be it, I think. So yeah, plan on having all of that done by Thanksgiving too. So this will be our second year hosting Thanksgiving here. So now we have seating for 8 plus 4 over there.
So yeah, we got plenty of space now. Yeah, let me show you guys how the other chairs look in my bedroom.
Yes. You want what?
I want more orange.
Okay, let me get Berkeley.
Let me get Berkeley some more oranges. Okay, let's go see these chairs.
Okay, so this is what the chairs are looking like in my room. So, So here we are. So yeah, they look really cute, cozy. Yeah, there they are.